While Repo: The Genetic Opera is a cult hit and has a strongly loyal fandom, it's not the best known movie. It was reviewed very negatively by critics, and it's the kind of film if, when seen on a store shelf by an uninitiated, will often be passed over for something less risky. So, while you're welcome to do what you do every episode and say, "This needed defending," in the comments, sod off and let me talk about an awesome film for once. Repo: The Genetic Opera is one of those films with a central premise so good it risks being a terrible film. You know the sort of things, the ones that hinge themselves on one clever idea and then can't back it up. Except Repo actually does back it up. It's set in a future where cosmetics and fashion have gone so far, people have organ transplants in the name of style, body part repossession has become en vogue. Anthony Stewart Head plays Nathan Wallace, one of the Repo Men. They're surgeons tasked with tracking down anybody who can't pay Jinko for their organ replacements, and they brutally take back its property. Oh, and it's an opera, the story unfolding almost entirely through song. So, a musical about a man who repossesses internal organs. Like I said, it's the kind of gimmicky premise a movie could skate by on, selling itself on novelty and nothing else. Except Repo goes above and beyond, telling a genuinely complex tale of betrayal and intrigue centered around Jinko boss Rotty Largo and his twisted plot of revenge, as well as his attempts to find a suitable inheritor for Jinko that isn't one of his kids. The vapid Amber Sweet, played not awfully by Paris Hilton, the murderous and wrathful Luigi, and my personal favourite, the woman's face-wearing sexual deviant Parvi. Meanwhile, Nathan cares for his daughter Shiloh, and his overbearing parenting becomes a major plot point in a story that is more intelligent and more involving than it has any right to be. The way Rotty Largo goes about setting up his cruel and unusual plot, the tragic backstories of all the major players, and the attention to operatic detail, such as having a Greek chorus analogue in the form of the Grave Robber, make for a film that's so much more clever than its initial presentation would have you believe. The film starts with a silly comic book plot setup and a campy song that lets you think you're in for an hour and a half of overacting nonsense. And you are, in a way. But you're also going to get so much more than that. There's not just a lot of heart and soul in Repo, but a lot of thought, a lot of brain. The songs, too, could have been throwaway novelties, but they're fantastic. Zydrate Anatomy is a classic, catchy, and undeniably awesome song in the beat department. Stuart Head is a famously excellent singer, and Paul Savino's pipes are beautifully suited to the more authentic operatic tunes. Other standout tracks include Chase the Morning, We Started This Opera Shit, and Night Surgeon, all highly memorable songs that deserve their place in any musical best of compilation. And the movie's look, any good sci-fi musical needs a strong, iconic look, and Repo has that in spades. Despite clearly not possessing the biggest budgets in the world, Repo works with what it has to produce something beautiful, something that looks unreal and colourful, yet grimy and sleazy at the same time. It's full of visuals that'll stick with you long after you've done watching. Repo deserves to be up there with all the other excellent tongue-in-cheek sci-fi musicals, alongside Rocky Horror, Little Shop of Horrors, and Return to the Forbidden Planet. It's silly, yes, and has all the trappings of a low-budget horror film, but it's smart, witty, and has fantastic tunes, and look at that man right there, how could you not love it?
My brother and sister should fuck.
Shut the fuck up!
Zydrate comes in a little glass vial.
A little glass vial?
A little glass vial!
And the little glass vial goes into the gun like a battery. And the Zydrate gun goes somewhere against your anatomy. And when the gun goes off, it's...